What's going on, my friends? I am Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about torquing. It sounds like I said twerking. So, should we be torquing our terminations? We hear electricians everywhere be like, hey, did you torque your screws on that plug before you put it in? Did you torque the terminals at your panel when you installed it? No, you don't hear that. You don't ever hear electricians say that. You hear inspectors say that, or you hear people in Facebook argue about it. But the amount of people out there that are going to every screw and every terminal and getting their clicky little torquing screwdrivers, nobody's doing that. There might be a couple people doing that, but most people aren't doing that. But should we be? That's what we're here to discuss. So there's a bunch of tools out there that people have made. One of them is like a screwdriver. Essentially, I don't have one. I should probably have one. This is a marker. But there's torquing screwdrivers, so you can set different values to them, and as you screw them in, you actually hear an audible click, and that's how you know that you've set that screw to a certain torque setting. There's clicking torque wrenches, so same kind of thing, just a bigger torque wrench. There are clicking the like button below. There's torquing. There are also clicking. No. Then there are torque wrenches that click, kind of like you should click the like button. It sounds so f***ing bad. I feel so f***ing cheesy saying that. Then there are torque wrenches that click, kind of like the sound it makes when you click the like button. It sounds funny in my head, but it's really not funny. Then there's even digital torque wrenches. So there's people that are making battery powered torque wrenches. So you can set values and everything in the tool. You just push a button and it actually does all of the work for you. So there's a lot of people making stuff for this, but does it necessarily apply to the electrical industry? Well, let's break into the code and see what the code says. All right, so do we have to torque as electricians? Yes. No. Kind of. There's a couple of municipalities in our area that require us to torque our terminations specifically at services, and they want us to take a marker or paint or something and actually mark between the screw part and the actual terminal where they go in, mark them to make sure that nothing has adjusted over time. That's what they want. So you always have to do what your AHJ, your authority having jurisdiction, wants you to do. That is also code. But what else does it say about code? So there's a whole new part in code in 110.14D. So this is what it reads. Under D, terminal connection torque, it says tightening torque values for terminal connections shall be as indicated on equipment or installation instructions provided by the manufacturer. Okay, so that's telling you that there should be torque values put on equipment or in the instructions of the equipment. Then it finishes by saying an approved means shall be used to achieve the indicated torque value. It doesn't say you have to torque. It just says the equipment has to have torque values on it. Informational note number one. Examples of approved means of achieving the indicated torque values include torque tools or devices. Include these things. That is not the only things. They include torque tools or devices such as shear bolts or breakaway style devices with visual indicators that demonstrate that the proper torque has been applied. Informational note number two, the equipment manufacturer can be contacted, not must be contacted. Means you, if there is no value, you don't have to go call them, but they can be contacted. Kind of funny that they even bother putting that in there. The equipment manufacturer can be contacted if numeric torque values are not indicated on the equipment or if the installation instructions are not available. Informative Annex I of UL Standard 486A through 486B, Standard for Safety Wire Connectors, provides torque values in the absence of manufacturer's recommendations. But it only does it for certain things, and we'll get that in a second. It's not for all things, it's very specific things. Informational note number three, additional information for torquing threaded connections and terminations can be found in section 8.10 of NFPA 70B-2019, recommended practice for electrical equipment maintenance. So that is everything. Nothing in there says that you have to torque. It just says that equipment needs to have torque values on it, and that if it does have torque values, or if it says anything in the instructions about torque values, that you need to use an approved means of torquing. Last thing I want to talk about is Annex I. I'm not going to talk about it much because there's not much to talk about, but it is worth at least mentioning. Annexes, again, just extra information. They're not requirements. They're recommendations in this case. So it says under informative Annex I, recommended tightening torque tables from UL standard 486A through 486B. In the absence of connector equipment manufacturer recommended torque values, table I1, I2, and I3 may be used to correctly tighten screw type connections. That's very specific, screw type connections only. For power and lighting circuits, control and signal circuits may require different torque values, and the manufacturer should be contacted for guidance. So there's different strandings, there's all kinds of different things. You can't really guarantee that something, just because it has a size screw, is gonna be the same. Like, basically, if you're tightening on one type of conductor, if you have a certain kind of insulation, there's certain things that can tighten a certain amount that might be able to fit into the same applications, but because of the specific application of wire or something that you're putting in there, the torque value is going to be different. So you can't really have a fixed torque value for everything across the board. It also says for proper termination of conductors, it's very important that the field connections be properly tightened. In the absence of manufacturer's instructions on the equipment, the torque values given in these tables are recommended, because it is normal for some relaxation to occur in service. Checking torque values sometime after installation is not a reliable means of determining the values of torque applied at installation. So, all that to say, should you? You know, it doesn't use the word shall. That's like the law in electrical code, right?
You shall do this.
Or it shall be permitted to be.
The word shall is not in there. It does not tell us that we have to torque, but we do have to follow manufacturer's instructions. So on one hand, like, should we, or like, you know, like, do you have to do it? No. Should you? Maybe. Depends. You know, if your inspector is going to make you do it, then, I mean, obviously, yeah. But the other side of it is, like, it's up to you to be doing work up to, like, whatever your standards are. Whatever you feel is a quality install, I always recommend people do work to impress themselves. Basically, when you step away from something and you look at it and you're checking off all the boxes in your head, do you feel like you just killed that install? Or when you walk away, are you kind of like, Jesus, I hope nobody ever sees that. I like to torque my terminations at services. When I, you know, in our area, it's kind of a practice, we have to do it, so I've just gotten used to doing it. So, but I'm not out here doing a custom home that's got like 1,050 receptacles and like getting a torquing screwdriver and torquing every single one of them. It's just, until like some kind of thing is like stamped down and demanded that I waste an extra 8 hours of time every single day going that extra mile, I'm just not going to do it. But if there is something, you know, personally, if there is something that comes out, I will follow it. But that's just my opinion though. I'm sure you got yours. Leave it below. Make sure that you guys are subscribed. If you're not subscribed, hit the like button if you like these videos. Hit the little notification dingy dingy, lets you know every time I have a new episode. Join the Discord server. Tons of cool people in there. A couple thousand electricians that like to just talk BS every day. And also, Facebook, if you're not into the Discord thing, Facebook's another one. We get like probably three times as many electricians in there, so just a good place to share knowledge. Go to the Electrician U subreddit. We started a subreddit, it's kind of small still. That's why I want you to go there. But that's the place I want you to post like funny, crazy, weird stuff. So like if you find really weird installs, you find just like haggard, messy crap, anything that's funny, if you're watching a TV show and they're doing something stupid and you're like, bro, that would never happen, like electrical in nature, send all that stuff. Use Reddit for that. I'm gonna start doing some kind of like reactionary videos. Anyways, enough talking at you. Love you crazy people. Thank you so much for watching and the constant support, and I will see you in the next one.
Discount music and video.